the church in Smyrna writes, I know your afflictions and your poverty, yet you are rich. I know about the slander of those who say they are Jews and are not, but are a synagogue of Satan. Do not be afraid of what you are about to suffer. I tell you, the devil will put some of you in prison to test you, and you will suffer persecution for 10 days. Be faithful, even to the point of death, and I will give you life as your victor's crown. Revelation 2, 8 through 10.
These engraved words were essentially opportunities to give rewards or brag about accomplishments of wealthy people or politicians or religious leaders, their athletic prowess in the games or for their strength in the gladiatorial rings. And the imagery of receiving a crown as a reward would have been really familiar to the people of Smyrna.
Having won the privilege from the Roman Senate by building the first temple in honor of Tiberius. Under Domitian, the emperor at the time of the writings of Revelation, emperor worship became compulsory for every Roman citizen on the threat of death. Once a year, a citizen had to burn incense on the altar to Caesar, after which he was issued a certificate. Now, obviously, this caused great turmoil for the Christ follower in the city. Smyrna was a city brimming with national pride, influence, and strong connections to the leaders of the largest empire in the world. And there, in this city, was a band of Christians living out their faith in a